Good afternoon, one and all. I welcome to this program. Now I am telling you a lesson which is useful in our future also. So I can get what is the lesson. I cannot tell what is the lesson name, but I can get answers through your side. That's why I am asking few questions. Please give answers. Can you solve the product? Vimala. 196. Okay, very good. Can you solve the another product? 5027. How can you do the product more than 10 into 10 digits by using calculator? No. How can you do the above product by using logarithm? How can you inform information immediately? By cell phone, by telegram, by speed post. How can you get information immediately from our head office to our schools daily? By emails, by cell phone. Did you see APSWIU's website? How? Yes, using computer with internet technology. How can you get results of public examination? Using computer with internet technology. So, now I am telling computing. Radical changes in our life, almost in all professions, are mainly used in computers, using computers. So, like digital media in education, computers are widely used in many fields, like education, communication, entertainment, banking, business, weather, forecasting and scientific researchers also. One of the example of a computer is PC computer. PC computers means personal computers. A personal computer is used one of the individual. So, a computer main part is, it contain main part is keyboard, second one is mouse, third one is monitor, fourth one is speaker, fifth one is CPU. So, one of the example of computer, laptop, it is keyboard, it is mouse. So, main part of a computer is first one is keyboard, second one is mouse, third one is monitor, fourth one is speaker, fifth one is central processing unit, abbreviation CPU. So keyboard and mouse are the input devices. Monitor and speaker is the output devices. Central processing is CPU. The definition of this computer is, it is a electronic device which accepts data and information as input and produces data as output. The block diagram of a computer is seen. Input. We are giving data to input. CPU. Input gives data to CPU. All the processes running on CPU. So, input gives data. We are giving whatever it is. It is arithmetic calculations, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, whatever calculations. That calculations, arithmetic calculations are done by ALU. And gives data to controller. If it the arithmetic logical unit, the process is running on, goes on increasing, then the control unit is controls that. Control unit gives data to memory unit and memory unit stores data. Memory unit gives data to output and display on monitor. Our printer. Let us come to over a long period, computers are developed. In some stages, we are calling as generations. First generation computers are vacuum tubes. Second generation computers are small transistors. Third generation computers are electronic circuits. Fourth generation computers are large scale integrated circuits, are very large scale integrated circuits. See. First generation computers are vacuum tubes. Second generation computers are small transistors. Third generation computers are electronic circuits. Fourth generation computers are large scale integrated circuits. vacuum tubes, small transistors, small electronic circuits, large integrated circuits. Note that point on your notes. Okay? Okay. Let us come to languages. Computer languages are mainly three. One is high level. Second one is binary. Third one is assembled. In assembled, again consists of it, four languages. See. First one is high level, second language is binary, third language is assembled. Assembled again consists of a Fortran, COBOL, BASIC, Pascal. Fortran means formula translation. See, F-O-R, for formula translation. Second one is COBOL. COBOL means common, C-O, common business oriented language. Third one is basic. Beginner all purpose symbolic instruction code. Pascal. Pascal means it is a one of the name. It is one of the language named after famous French mathematician Blaise Pascal. Okay? Note that point on your notes. Let us come to characteristics. Characteristics of a computer is it can perform arithmetic and logical operations. It can perform calculations with high speed. They do not get bored, but man get bored and tired, but computers cannot get bored. It can obey the instructions most obediently. Man can obey the instructions most obediently? No. A computer can obey the instructions most obediently. Okay? Let us come to algorithm. What is algorithm? A algorithm is a set of instructions which leads to step-by-step procedure on a computer. It is called algorithm. See. Let us come to flowchart. What is flowchart? Yes, flowchart is a nothing but algorithm. We are telling set of instructions, it's called algorithm. A set of instructions shown on diagrammatic or pictorial representation is called flowchart. The correct definition of a flowchart is a flowchart is a diagrammatic and pictorial representation for sequence of steps for solving a problem on a computer is called flowchart. Once you draw a flowchart, we can use mainly four symbols. One is terminal. Second one is process. Third one is input, output. Fourth one is decision. See. It is symbol of terminal. A terminal symbol is used denotes start, stop, or end. If you draw a flowchart, start, we can get this symbol, terminal. Okay? Are you understanding? Yeah. Let us come to second one. Next symbol is process. Is a rectangular shape. A process is, if you draw a flowchart, define execution. The process comes in so many times. If you do process, the process comes so long. If you use this symbol on it. Okay? Let us come to third one. Input output. Make available information for processing is called input. Recording of processed information is called output. Let us come to fourth one. Fourth one is decision. Is it rhombus shape? What is decision? If you take decision, a tiny point, that decision may be yes or no, true or false, whatever it is, that decision may be yes or no. We have kept this. These four symbols are using after draw flowchart with algorithm. See. Symbols of a flowchart is, one is terminal, second one is process, third one is input-output, fourth one is decision. Terminal denotes start, stop. Process denotes define execution. We cannot tell any order. Input-output, information for processing and recording of information. Of processed information is called input output. Fourth one is decision. If you take decision, it may be yes or no, true or false, like one of the example of a flowchart and algorithm. See here. Simple example of algorithm. So, from start and steps to read ABC. Step 3 is A greater than B. Then, if A greater than C, then print A, else go to step 5. Step 4. So, we can draw stepwise direction. This is called algorithm. Let us come to flowchart. see, we can use start, use this symbol terminal and use decision. We can use process symbol. So the process is goes on increasing. That's why we are using read ADC process symbol. Third one is decision. If you take the decision, may be yes or no, true or false, whatever it is, we are taking decision. If A greater than B, if it is yes, we are going to next step. So A greater than C, it is also decision we are taking. Next step is input output. So that is the correct data through end of this flowchart. Correct data, process recording data is print A. We are using this input output symbol. Let us come to one of the example of the flowchart. A Gopal takes and purchases a radio with 500 rupees. We are calling cost price, CP. And sell at 600 rupees. We are calling selling price. See, if Gopal gets gain or loss, can tell Krishna? If Gopal gets gain or loss, gain. What is the formula of gain? SP minus CP. What is Gopal? How Gopal sells it? How much of rupees? 600 rupees. And cost and purchase it how much? 500 rupees. So Gopal get gain how much? 100 rupees. Next, gain percentage. What is the formula of gain percentage? We are getting gain. Yeah, gain by CP into 100. How much gain? 100 rupees. See, 100 ones, 100 five ones, 520. Okay? Gopal get how much of gain percentage? 20%. So, if you draw stepwise, it is called algorithm. Let us come to flowchart. If you think, so if you are getting a, with the given data, this type of process, we can get lost. What is the loss percentage? CP minus SP. What is the loss percentage? Now you tell me. Now you know you loss percentage. the formula of loss percentage? Simple. Gain is it? We are getting gain. We are kept gain. If we are getting loss, we are get loss. Kept loss. Loss by CP into 100. Print. Print. Loss is equal to how much? Loss percent is equal to how much? Same as gain. If you think we are getting gain, you are lost gain. If you are getting loss, you are kept loss. If it is equal to CP is equal to SP, on the 10, how can you get? On the 10, you can draw. If it is equal to CP, CP is equal to SP, we can plot in flowchart. We write neither gain nor not. Loss. We are getting gain? No. We are getting loss? No. If it is equal, CP is equal to SP. Okay? See, one of the examples of a flowchart. It is a problem. From start, in area, I am telling what is from start to end. We are using this symbol, terminal. That's why I am kept terminal symbol. Next. We have checked some of the examples, CP, how much, SP, how much, we have got here. So, I am taking CP is equal to 500. And SP is equal to 600. If you take gain or loss, if you get gain, the decision